In this video, I want to introduce the viruses to you. So far in this class, we've talked so much about the prokaryotes, the bacteria and the archaea, and it's really, really important that you have a solid, clear distinction in your mind between the viruses and the cellular life forms. Viruses are not cellular, and in fact, by most definitions, they're not even alive. And yet we lump them into microorganisms because they cause disease and they have a life cycle. It's just a life cycle that requires other organisms. So one of the basic fundamental things that I want you to take away from this class are the distinctions between the viruses and the bacteria in particular, because it's so easy in culture to just lump those together, and yet they're really quite distinct. So we'll look at a couple different ways of defining the viruses, and then we'll look at some visuals, because it's also important in any of the microbial or molecular sciences to develop that scientifically accurate imagination. And so I want you to have some good visuals of what viruses are all about. Let's start with a simple definition of obligate intracellular parasites. We can break all three of these terms down. Obligate means required, right, or necessary, not an option. Intracellular means within living cells. And parasite means a relationship between organisms in which one benefits, but the other is harmed. So, what does this tell us? It's absolutely essential for a virus to get inside living cells. They have to be intracellular. There's no viral infection, no viral activity outside of cells. If there are viruses in the bloodstream, yes, it may indicate there are problems, but the viruses in the bloodstream themselves don't represent an infection. They can't replicate. They can't replicate on a petri dish or in a broth. They have to have living cells to get inside, and by definition, they have to parasitize those cells. It's not going to be some sort of a friendly symbiosis like a mutualism or even a commensalism where one benefits and the other sort of could care less. They have to actually parasitize their host cell and harm their host cell in the process. Very important fundamental definition of viruses. Here's a more textbook definition. Submicroscopic, meaning smaller than we can see with the compound light microscope. Parasitic, right? They have to actually harm and parasitize their host. A filterable agent is an old term that we used to use a long time ago before we really had more of a sense of what these things were. We just knew that if we took body fluids from people who were infected, in some cases, filtering those body fluids did not render them non-infectious. Something was passing through those filters that was small enough to pass through the filters and remain infectious. And so we often call them filterable agents. And really, all they are at their heart is a nucleic acid, and we'll see what those are, the different versions of nucleic acids that they can use in a later video, protected by a protein coat. That's it. Nucleic acid with very simple information, very few genes, somewhere around, you know, 5 to 15 genes is pretty typical for a virus. That's just protected by a protein coat so it can get from one host cell to another. We're going to see in the upcoming videos that their genome includes DNA or RNA, but not both, that they have a protein coat, and as we've talked about, they're obligate intracellular parasites. Now, in red at the bottom, I've got a little less of a textbook definition, but it might be a more helpful one for you. Viruses are protein-coated nucleic acids, no metabolism of their own, that hijack the host cell's metabolic machinery. That's important. They get inside a host cell and they take over that cell. And they turn that cell into nothing more than a machine to serve their own, that should say their own diabolical purposes, because really there's no benefit to us. They're just pure purpose, pure replication, make more of myself and I will survive. And that's all that's going on with these little viruses. So they get inside a host cell, they take over the host cell, they shut down most of its normal functions, and they turn it just into a little factory to make more of the virus. Here's some images of viruses to give you a little bit of a visual sense of what they're all about. In the upper left, we've got an adenovirus, one of many, many classes of viruses that can cause mild upper respiratory illness, what we think of as the common cold. And you can see they're very symmetrical, very geometric in shape, and that becomes important. Upper right, you've got an influenza virus. They look a little less geometric. They look kind of squishy. It's because they have a membrane wrapped around them that's an optional component, something that we don't see in all viruses, but some actually have this membrane wrapped around them. We'll talk about where that envelope comes from. In the bottom left here, you've got Ebola virus. And you can see it's actually kind of long and squiggly looking. It doesn't move, although it looks like from that picture it ought to be wiggling around. It just sort of sits there. Remember, it's a virus. No metabolism, no energetics, nothing on its own. In the bottom right, you have a phage. This is one of the T. even phages. Phage are viruses that infect only bacteria. We've actually learned a lot from the phage, and so we're going to discuss phage in a later video. All right, let's summarize. Viruses, number one, are not alive. You've got to understand that. These things do not have a metabolism of their own. There's no respiration, no fermentation. They're not using an ATP budget. They're not building things. They're not breaking things down. They do nothing. They are just information that shuts down a cell and has that cell replicate more information. And then it's protected by a protein coat, so it's going to last a little bit longer when it's not inside a cell. But we've got to understand they're not alive. So not alive. They have to parasitize a living cell in order to carry out their life cycle. No other way for them to survive. And they are really nothing more than nucleic acid wrapped in a protective protein coat. We'll see a few variations on that theme, but at their most fundamental, that's all a virus is. So I hope this introduction really gave you some insight into what viruses are. And so in the following lectures, we're going to drill down a little bit deeper and look at the physical structure and the life cycles of viruses. Thanks for joining me.